How's it going, man?
It's good. How's it going?
Good. It's going great. We're going fishing for 2 fucking days.
Yeah, right.
Everything's beautiful. Did you talk to... Dude, you'll be fine, dude. Just remember, just keep your thumb on the spool, dude.
Yeah.
That's the first rule with this type of reel. That's going to be the hardest thing for you to get. If you've been using spinning gear, you know, it's a little different because it wants to free spool. You know, there's no clicker or nothing. It just wants to spin whatever way you're swinging it. Well, obviously, there's going to be a bait, you know, a jig, something on the end of it, and it wants to fling out. What happens is it'll double up over itself and it'll do like the beginning of a rat's nest. So yeah, that's pretty much the gist of it. So if you keep your thumb on it, you're gonna be fine.
Guys,
and fingers on a galley, all that kind of good stuff. So, how's everybody doing tonight?
Great.
You guys ready to have some fun and catch some fish?
Yeah.
That's what I want to hear. All right. My name is Rick Podolak. I'll be your captain for this trip. One of the captains, anyway. The rest of the crew, I guess, I've heard a lot of good things about this group for the most part. Knock on wood, it's all good. So anyhow, most of you guys know the rest of the crew here. We've got our fearless Chef Jeff, Kazi, Cody, Julio, and again, my name's Rick. Gang, as always, sit back, relax, enjoy the boat's yours, get our bait loaded. We're out of Dodge here. For the most part, we will be fishing offshore. It's lucrative fishing now. We are starting to see the first true waves of yellowfin tuna and skipjack tuna roll on in here now. It was just yellowtail and dorado last week, but we're catching a little bit of everything now. For the most part, we're fishing just outside of Ensenada as far as this tuna and skipjack is concerned. We're going to get started on that first, I think. And then the dorado and yellowtail have been a little bit further southwest, is where some of the better kelps have been. We have been catching a little bit of dorado to go with this tuna, but some of the really good floating kelp patties have been a little further into the south and a little further into the south-southwest. So we'll be playing the tuna game a little bit, and then we'll be playing the dorado and the yellowtail game. Today was kind of hit and miss compared to the last couple of days prior to that. Some of the guys struggled a little bit.
That looks nice.
And some of the guys had tremendous days, and it was everything in between. So let's just hope tomorrow's going to be one of those banner days for us. This boat's been on a roll. Knock on wood, hopefully we can keep it going here. As far as this tuna goes, guys, there's been a lot of jig strikes. A lot of it's visual fish, a lot of it's fish that we see on our machinery, a lot of it's just blind strikes, but it's a lot of action, a lot of strikes. When we catch 1, 2, 3, 4 fish, we're on our way again, and then some of these spots are tremendous breezers, where we'll circle around them, we'll get our strikes, and we're sitting for an hour, and everybody's busy. So it's a little bit of everything. Don't get discouraged if we arrive on scene and we're just one and two and I'm a dad. As most you know, it just takes one good big stop, and there's been some doozies around. Same thing with the kelp, too. Some of these kelps have nothing on them. Some kelps we catch 1, 2, 3 fish, and some kelps we catch a couple hundred and makes our trip. It's what I call payoff kelp. So trial and error, both in the tuna game and on the dorado game. All right? For those of you that might be new at this, I know we do have some rental rods on the boat. You guys want to be Johnny on the spot, especially with this tuna. With the kelp patty fishing, I give you guys a little bit of heads up when we see them. I give you guys a little bit of a chance. You know, we've got a mile to go, quarter mile to go. You've got a little bit of time to get out of the galley, grab your rod. when we're striking up tuna and stuff, you guys want to be as close to that rear bait tank as you guys can with rod in hand, literally rod in hand, ready to roll. As soon as you hear the guys yell, hook up, and those rods go off, those trolling rods go off, you want to get the bait in the water as fast as you can. I'll let you guys know what the proper side of the boat is gonna be. You always want to have the wind in your face. The wind's in your face, you're in the right place, okay? Standard gear with this size fish, this yellowfin has been anywhere from 5-pounders to 25-pounders and everything in between. 20 to 30 pound test, I would think 25 pound test is a good starting test. Most of this bait, and they're eating the hell out of it too, is a smaller bait depth. But we do have some larger deans in our slammers just in case. We're kind of holding on to that for the prime stop. But for the most part, again, 20 to 30 pound, 25 for starters, a straight two hook is going to work just fine. All right.
Yeah, I don't think that's my bait pulling that hard.
Yeah.
Right, Skip.
Huh?
Skippy. Sorry. Oh.
I knew he was fucking bad. Pull over.
Come on.
Always make sure you're fishing with these reels out of gear now.
Six.
Family to the boat.
Okay, cross the stern on the right hand side of the boat this time, starboard side.
Bubba.
Done.
Hooking us up.
Yippee!
Nope.
rods, but they need to be cinched down a little more.
Oh, they're down.
Just fine, dude. Just fine.
Sat there for a second and it got bit. There's a bunch of, did you see all the fish in the water?
Yeah.
A fucking bunch
of them. How do I drop this?
So keep your put your thumb on it with this hand. Yep, like that exactly, and then you drop that back. You fill it, click, fill it. Yep, unclip it. Just fine, dude. Just fine. Get a bait in the water.
Oh, mine just popped. Both of them. river too short, just go right off the back of the boat. Throw bait in?
Yeah.
Okay. Hell yeah.
Sorry. Ah, that boy's right down right now.
fighter.
Nice. Those are up.
No.
Fucking mega bait.
No. I'm talking.
Oh. Come on, for me, Mark. Skippy. You damn Skippy. And he's gone. I didn't want you anyway.